New at 10, the controversial horse slaughterhouse in Roswell is set to open for business by next month. That is according to the company's lawyer. Well, now an animal rights activist is actually backing the slaughter company. Action 7 News reporter Melissa Colorado spoke to the activist who says she'd rather see horses slaughtered humanely than see them starve to death.
For more than a year, Valley Meat Company has tried to open up the country's only horse slaughterhouse in Roswell. There were death threats from animal rights activists and legal hurdles. Last year, the company's owner, Rick De Los Santos, filed a lawsuit against the United States Department of Agriculture to get the USDA to resume inspections. Valley Meat's lawyer says the USDA is moving forward with the approval process. That means opening day for the horse slaughterhouse is just around the corner.
As far as we know, still from the Department of Justice and from USDA, we will be ready to open here in the next few weeks.
But since a video surfaced last week showing a former Valley Meat Company employee shooting a horse in the head, the death threats have doubled.
I got threatened with arson. I understand that Rick DeSantos is being threatened with a firebomb.
Marcy Britton is an animal rights activist that is openly supporting the horse slaughterhouse. Britton says the overpopulation of abandoned and wild horses leads to something way worse than slaughter: starvation.
It takes about 2 months for a horse to starve to death, and it's gruesome cruelty.
Each year, hundreds of thousands of horses are shipped to Mexico and Canada for slaughter. Britton doesn't want horses to die, but at least
death at a slaughterhouse is instantaneous.
The company's attorney says after the USDA conducts one final inspection of the plant, the horse slaughterhouse will open for business. The owner has also hired a security team for his employees and for his own safety. Royal.
Okay, thank you, Melissa. Valley Meat Company says the horse meat from the Roswell plant will be shipped for human consumption to Russia, Eastern Europe, and Asia. The meat will also be used for pet food.